woman bleeding and in pain after she was attacked by a jaguar. And that is where our coverage begins tonight. We want to thank you for joining us. I'm Danielle Lerner.
I'm Dan Spindle. Right now, that woman is recovering after being scratched by a jaguar at Wildlife World Zoo and Aquarium. Zoo officials telling us it happened because of human error by that guest. ABC 15's John Treweiler live there tonight. What do we know, John?
Well, Dan and Danielle, that scratch pretty deep on that woman's arm. This all happening just before the zoo was about to close for the evening. We do have some video we can show you of moments after this incident. A warning, it's pretty graphic, and we've blurred part of it. But we can show it to you. You can see the female guest laying on the ground, calling out in pain as others are around her trying to help her. The zoo director this evening telling us that that guest went over a barrier and got up to the fence line of the jaguar's enclosure, got close enough and was attempting to take a selfie with the animal. As a result, that jaguar's claws were able to get through the fence and scratch the guest. The zoo's message tonight is very simple. Their barriers are in place for a reason.
I think you observe the barrier. They're there for a good reason. We try to keep everyone safe. We have an excellent safety record here with all of our animals. For the past 35 years, Wildlife World Zoo has served literally hundreds of thousands and over a million customers with very few injuries, and usually those injuries result from misbehavior of the visitor or human error.
Now, the zoo director also telling us tonight this is actually the second time that this jaguar has scratched a guest. We're told it previously happened out here because of a similar incident when a guest got too close to the fence line and went over a barrier. The zoo says they will not be euthanizing this animal because the animal did nothing wrong. It is not the animal's fault. That female woman, or that woman who was a guest out here, we're told is in her 30s, and she was transported by Rural Metro Fire with non-life-threatening injuries. Dan and Danielle, we are live in Litchfield Park tonight. I'm John Treweiler, ABC 15, Arizona.
Okay. I saw this story trending on my Twitter last night, and I literally was like, whoa, okay, let me look into this and see what happened, because you know animal attacks happen quite often. But when I saw that this woman was that much of an idiot to climb over that barrier to try to take a picture with it. Now, I didn't know that the woman was trying to take a selfie with the animal. So that means she got really, really close to this jaguar. Now, this isn't the actual jaguar that attacked her, but this is just a picture I found on Google of a jaguar. And when I heard that, I'm like, I hope they don't expect me or anybody else to really feel sorry for her, at least those who have a logical brain. Actually, like many others, we were concerned and hope that they didn't put down the animal, because when I reposted it on my timeline, a lot of the people were asking me, please tell me nothing happened to the animal. And I said, no, nothing happened, because like the zookeeper said, that they can't euthanize an animal when the animal was the one being provoked. It's not like the jaguar jumped over the barrier and came in and attacked this woman. She went to it knowing that there were signs of saying, do not get too close. These barriers are up for a reason, or something to that effect. Now, I did see the video, like the raw video, where she's laying on the ground after being scratched by the animal. She's lucky all she got was a scratch, because that was a pretty deep scratch. Like, she's definitely going to have to get a lot of stitches and surgery to close that wound back up, because you can literally see the white meat in her arm, like when I saw the actual raw video. And the fact that this happened twice, you mean someone actually risked their life to do this a second time? Well, not this person, the same person, but with the same jaguar. Like, what? Like, why? You know, there's actually a place over in Thailand, and some of you, if you have an Instagram account, you probably have seen people go over there where they have like a, I guess you could say a preservation, where people can actually go there and actually take pictures very close up with animals and actually pet them. Some people even take pictures while they're sitting next to them, or even laying on top of the animal, like a tiger or something like that. And basically they're trained for that. These animals right here are not trained to adapt to people like that, because they will see you as the prey. They'll see you as you trying to attack them. That's why they have trained professionals deal with these type of creatures. you are not that trained professional. They only see you as a intruder. And what happens when you see an intruder, you attack in hopes that the intruder does not come back. So this woman, because it was a woman who did this, is a dumbass. And she should consider herself extremely lucky that all she got was a scratch across the arm at that. And that animal was not able to break free of its surroundings and maul her to death. Y'all let me know what you think about this down in the comments. Like, share, subscribe. I'll talk to you in the next one. Oh, I feel absolutely nothing for this woman's injuries.